You guys beat me out here. How you doing? Cleaning up last night's poop from the possum? Here we go. My daily ritual. Unlocking the chicken door. Yeah. Cry havoc and release the chickens of war. Fear my chickens and my furry beasts. Come on, babies. Hey, birds. Hey, birds. Hey. Aha, treats. And buckets of goodness. Here, eat something. I made it rain. This is not just for the chickens. This is actually just a snack for the chickens, but mostly for all those birds you hear out here. Blackbirds, sparrows, bunnies. That was, hi. Rabbits, chipmunks, all kinds of wild birds come over here to eat. I don't have a regular bird feeder. I just have this. And they come over here, they eat all of this grain. And I also have a water bowl here that I keep full, filled with fresh water to make sure everybody has some fresh water. Just in case we don't get any rain, I want to make sure that everybody gets what they want. Hey, you! You're throwing a little fit, aren't you? Here. Chew on that. Yay! Now, I gotta run in and I gotta feed the little army, the armyette, my backup army, and then I'll be right out, okay? Hey, everybody! You too. Oh, you're all alive. Yay, that's a bonus. Okay, you chew on that. I'll be right back. Chickies get fed first. Hey, you don't hate me so much anymore, do you? Yeah, it's exciting when Daddy comes here now. Yeah, I got a little container of food. The bread, this is going to go to Lewis and Bucky. The other bread is going to the turkey over there. I'll explain the turkey in just a second. But for right now, hey birds.
Hip, hip.
I'm teaching them the same thing that I teach the other birds out there. I call them, hey birds, hip, hip. That means breakfast. That's a mixture of sunflower seeds, scratch grain, and chick starter. I'm trying to wean them off of the chick starter because once they're big enough to not fit through the outside fence, they're going out. I don't have any need to have them in here. Okay, that's done. Bread goes down here. They stand on their water and they poop in their water overnight, so that goes out here because that's just going to make good compost for later, but for right now it makes for a really bad milkshake. Here, I'm going to flip this around, fill it full of fresh water, and then I know what you're waiting for, you little piranhas. I don't want to be in there when they start pecking. I could lose a shoe. You little boogers. All right, you ready? Okay, and there we go. Oh, it's nuts. Just a slice of bread. It gives them the opportunity to play keep away and have fun. Okay, that's done. Yeah, before you eat my microphone, I gotta feed everybody else. This never gets old. It gets them going. And little tiny Tim over there, he hops around too. He can't keep up with the other ones to steal a piece of bread, but they're clumsy and they'll drop a piece of bread and he'll get some. Plus, that's just a snack. That's just fun stuff. There's good quality grain right there in that bowl. So I have no sympathy for little tiny Tim, although I have a lot of affection. Okay, you little piglet. This is a piece of French bread that I left out overnight. It's hard, so it gives him something to chew on and crunch. Hey, Bucky. You too. Hey, chickens. Here, go chew on that. Chase yourselves around. That's pretty good stuff. Yeah. They like to chew on something that has some kind of texture to it, the goats. So I let the bread dry up. And I have one more fresh slice of bread that, of course, he thinks he has to have. Get away from me. You pig, you. It's like playing football. People ask me if I've ever played sports. No, but I have a goat. Come on. Get. I'm going to step on the turkey. Here, eat this over here. Hey, turkey. Yeah, that's good. This is my last turkey over here. And I make sure she gets as much bread as she'll eat in one shot. Come on, eat that. Eat that. There you go. I swear, that goat is quick. And I add to her container of fresh water, trying to keep my microphone out of Lewis's mouth. The turkey has problems, and she's had problems for weeks now. I have to go really slow around her, and I bring her a bowl of water, and also a bowl of food. I save a little bit of this food for her. I put the majority of it here in the main feeder for the flock, and then in a little bowl that, of course, Lewis thinks is his, I add some more. And this is mainly for her to chew on. And I got to move slow, because if I move too fast, she stands up. And I don't want her to stand up. Something happened, and I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's a congenital thing or if Lewis just stomped on her. I don't know. I'm not out here all the time. She can't walk very well. And I'm thinking it might have something to do with genetics, because this happened to the males at certain times, and they were outside almost all the time. And I know he doesn't stomp on them. He has no interest in the turkeys at all, or chickens. He doesn't nibble on them, doesn't run on them or anything. And he's always been very careful since he was a baby. I think there's something going on with their bones. Maybe they're just a bad genetic line. But she has problems standing up. She can stand and walk a few steps, but she has to flap her wings for balance and also to stay up. And then she'll just sit down. And she was doing that outside. I wondered why she didn't come out inside for a couple days. So I brought her in. I had to carry her in, flapping and not liking it at all. But she stays in here with the lights on during the day. I bring her food, water, and I also bring her greens from outside, a bowl of greens. I get out there and I pick clover, grass, dandelions, and I also come in here and give her some attention. That's my daily thing for her. I can't fix her, but I can at least make her comfortable. I do the best that I can, like I always say, with what I have to work with. I don't have much to work with her, but I can keep her comfortable. Let me give the turkeys some water over here. I know, you're ticked off. You can't have everything. You pig, you. All right, I'm getting out of here before you eat something electronic. What? There's no rat. There's no mouse. And then, of course, I got the littles out here waiting to see if I bring out a rat from the rat trap or a mouse. But no, I haven't had the rat traps set for quite a while because I don't want to get the birds stuck in it. As soon as the little chickens come out here, then I can put the rat traps out again. Okay. Why don't you go eat something? Look at all that green. Look at what I do for you. You spoiled baby. Yeah, that's good. Well, I got things to do. The sun's almost coming up, and I don't want to have the sun in my face. Plus, we're having 90-degree weather out here. I know some people don't think that's very bad, but for me, with the humidity, that's nasty. So I got to get out here as soon as possible, get everything done, and go inside, hide from the heat of the day, and then come out later on in the evening and get everything done. I got something in the mail today that I got to get planted, and I also got to check the garden and make sure everything gets water because we didn't get any rain last night. So I'm going to put these away. And we'll get started. Inside this wax paper, there was some moist paper. And then inside of that were these. These are called sweet potato slips. All they are little pieces of plant that were rooted and are ready to plant. I'm assuming, since I know absolutely zip about sweet potatoes, I'm assuming this is how they arrive for you. A friend, Ray, he ordered me sweet potatoes. Now, people have asked me throughout the years, Ray, have you ever grown sweet potatoes? Ray, have you ever grown sweet potatoes? My answer has always been an instant no. Well, now my answer will not be no anymore, because I'm going to try to grow these. I don't know how it's going to work, because I don't know if it's warm enough here for me to grow sweet potatoes. Plus, I'm not growing them in the sunshine. I have to grow them over here, kind of in the shade. They're going to get some afternoon sunlight. So I'm crossing my fingers and hoping they grow. I don't have room in my garden to grow sweet potatoes. I already have it planned out for all the things that I want to grow. And by the way, I'm going to be showing you all of those things in an update today. It's a full episode today. It is a grand old gardening episode. Good old-fashioned stuff that you've grown to love here. But I do want to plant these things to see if they will grow here. What the heck? I'm going to probably try to take one into the voodoo garden and grow it. But the rest of them, I'm going to grow out here. I'm going to show you how I do that later on in the program. But before the sun comes up, I got to get down to the Lower Unctan Garden. I want to show you updates on things that I've already planted. How's that sound? Let me go put these away so that nobody eats them. And let's head on down. Come on, dogs. It smells damp. That's good, though. The morning dew is great for plants. Mother Nature really does things that we can't do as gardeners for our garden. Like when it rains, you've noticed that whenever... Hi. How you doing? You notice that when you water your garden, it does okay. But when it rains, everything just goes pop. And it just grows fantastic. Something about Mother Nature, she, even though it's just water, Mother Nature can give your plants something that you can't. Let's go. I'm going to grab you and we're going to head on over there. Look at that sunrise. Isn't that something? Iowa sunrise. I'm going to start over here. What the heck? Look at this. Remember the potato planting? What a difference just a few weeks makes. It took them about a week and a half. Yep, there's 9 plants in here. Actually, 9 groups of plants. I planted them about 3 weeks ago, give or take. It took a week and a half for them to come up. And then it took a week and a half for them to get over a foot tall. The warm Iowa sunshine and plenty of rich, well-drained soil. I want to give you close-ups because I want to do some proper updates on this. Look at this. Not just a plant. They have groups of plants in here. Yep. They're healthy. They're strong. They're growing fast. And I've been keeping them weeded as much as possible. Once they're more mature, they're going to shade out this area beautifully and help keep weeds down by themselves. But before they start shading it out, you definitely want to keep it weeded. Get in here, get off your lazy butt, and pull those weeds. And I have to do that almost constantly. I just pull them and then drop them right here. Let them decompose. As they decompose, the worms will come over here and they'll munch on their corpses. My little zombie army of worms. Yep, that's all I have to do to keep them healthy. And when I do water potatoes, I don't water them frequently. I water them deep and not very often. Okay, let the top of the soil stay dry and you'll have a whole lot less problems with blight and other issues concerning moisture. And so that's my tip for potatoes. Water them deep, leave them, water them again, leave them. And let's back up and we're gonna sweep over, ring around the dill. Look at this, dill all the way around. That's what we have planted over here. And then the center attraction, let me lean in. I got a fence around it because I don't want any mice, rats, or birds pecking it. This is a sunflower, and I don't know what brand it is, but it's a giant sunflower. I want to give it some protection because when you plant sunflowers, you may have noticed this. I don't know if you do or not, but with me, the mice love to just chop them down. They chop them down at ground level as soon as they sprout. So what I do is I put a little fence around it temporarily, and then once they're about a foot tall, then I can let them grow naturally without the fence around them. But until then, no, they need a guard, and that's me. So I put this little hardware cloth around them, and that's going to be the centerpiece right there, a giant sunflower in my raised bed. That's going to be a hoot. And then over here, I planted, somebody sent me, I forgot her name, I'm really sorry about that, but that's just how I roll, I forget names. She sent me cucamelon. Yeah, cucamelon or wild cucumber. Not the spiny ones, but they're supposed to look like little watermelons. She sent me 3 seeds and I planted them here and I believe that's one of them. So that one is supposed to grow up and then it's going to grow along the fence and then put out little baby pickles or whatever it's supposed to grow. Swinging on down to here. Today's project after the sun goes down later on today is to weed the onions. These are the Kelsey onions. I planted these. I did a program on this. It's kind of hard to see them in with the grass because the grass comes up daily. Yep, this is a never-ending thing for me. It's pulling out these crazy grasses and laying them down, and then more come out. This is just what I do, and I could mulch, and I probably will, but not right yet. I'm going to use mowed grass as a mulch. That's a wonderful thing to use, and you can see I have plenty of lawn. Thing is in early spring, the dandelions come out. And I don't want to be mulching this with grass with dandelion seeds in it because it'll just make my issues worse. So what I'm doing is waiting till dandelion season is over. We have a wave of how things go around here. Dandelions come out in early spring to feed the first pollinators. I let them go to seed. They blow all over the place. I'm a horrible neighbor if you don't like dandelions. But it helps them spread out. Then once the dandelions are done, then the clover comes out. Okay, now clover is not that big of a problem. Clover will actually help your garden because it brings nitrogen into it. So once the clover is growing, and that should be in the next few weeks, I'm going to mow the lawn, bag it, and then the grass and the clover, I'm going to put in the rows here for the onions as a mulch to keep the weeds down. I'm going to see how that works for me so I don't have to work quite as hard. Onions don't compete very well with weeds. So I'm going to pick the weeds until I get the mulch in here, and then hopefully these Kelsies will get nice and big. They're looking pretty healthy. They don't require a lot of water. You just water them, let them dry out, water them. Same thing with the potatoes. Right down here, the leftovers of those flowers, my tulips already bloomed, and you can see the remains of the petals. And then right up at the top, they were pollinated, and I believe this is going to be a seed pod. Yes, a tulip seed pod right at the tops. It's kind of neat. I'm going to save the seeds from this, and I don't know what I'll do with them. Probably find another place to plant them. And then over here, this Boxcar Willie. Yeah, Boxcar Willie. That was, remember when I planted, I had that zombie garden planting thing? I showed you those plants. That was just a few weeks ago, and about 3 weeks ago that I planted those. I did it around the same time I did the potatoes. I just brought this thing out here, shoved it in the ground, no big deal. I didn't plant it extra deep because I wanted to see how it's going to work. Just one tomato plant in this huge bed. I've been keeping it weeded, but once this plant gets going, it's not going to need any weeding at all. It can take really good care of itself. Now, I want to bring up one thing. When you're planting your tomatoes, sometimes, now it may be too late to worry about it this year, but next year you have plenty of time to worry. When you plant your tomatoes outside, sometimes the leaves will start curling, and it'll be the newer leaves. You'll see them all curled up and stuff, and you wonder, what's going wrong with my tomato? That is a stress reaction. Remember that. It's harmless. It's just a stress reaction to the cooler temperatures or the change in environment. But when it warms up and the roots get down underneath this tomato and get going, it goes away. This had a classic stress reaction, but now it's starting to grow and starting to put out flowers, early spring flowers in the Boxcar Willie. This is a beauty. It's got a nice strong stem, but it's not planted deep, so I don't have all these suckers underneath the ground. My plan on this year is to try something a little different. Not that I don't like my other method, but I grow that every year. This year what I'm going to do is I'm going to run these suckers above ground, then over to the side and run them up a bamboo pole. So this is going to be like a hand, like this. The main plant's going to be in the middle, then the suckers are going to go out to the edges and then go up on bamboo poles so nothing rides on the ground and it keeps it drier and less chance of blight on the leaves. I don't really have that much of a problem with blight because I don't water it that much. But some people do not have the opportunity to plant them deep like I do and not worry about watering. So I'm going to try a little bit different and see if I can come up with a solution to the blight issue and the moisture issue. And not that it helps me any because I grow them a different way, but if it can help you, I figure why not give it a shot. Hey, you little badger. And he does serve a function in here. So he's sniffing the corners and he checks. Oh, that's an ant nest. You don't want to get your nose too close in there. That can go right up your snout. But he checks for mice. Yes, he does. And my little weeders, they're always chewing on something. And I have no problems whatsoever with these dogs in my garden. They walk through the garden. I didn't even have to train these two. Rascal, he was already trained. Well, thank you. Just pee right there, you little pig. They don't eat any of the plants. So when people warn me, Ray, watch out for poisonous plants that dogs can't eat, I don't worry about that because my dogs don't do that. They have no interest in that whatsoever. Yeah. Smell the sweet potatoes? Smell kind of nice, huh? Yes, they do. Yeah, well, I didn't have a garden space for these, so I had no idea what to do. My plan is right here by the picnic table by the chicken coop. I have this old tree, but on this side of the tree, there's an opening between these trees where the sun comes through. This area right here slopes down and it faces south. So I'm hoping, I don't know, I'm hoping that it'll get some kind of sun here. It may or may not, but I really have nowhere else to plant these things where they're not going to just take over all over the place. So I figured, what the heck, I'm going to grow some of them here and see how they do. So here we go. Now, let's hope we don't fall. Hold on. Hey, Tiki. You're in my way. You can't be here. Come on. Get a little butt out of here. She's got to know what I'm doing, where I'm doing it, and when I'll be done, so that I can give her all of my attention. I just had an idea. I can plant one or two of these in a certain area of my garden. Now this old dirt, I don't have much confidence it's gonna be that rich, but it sure does seem to grow the weeds here. Look at this, I think these are nettles. I'm not sure. I have no idea what that is. I have no idea what you are. I hope you're not poisonous. All kinds of other stuff grows here. So I figured, why not sweet potatoes? I'm not gonna give any kind of in-depth demo on these because, like I said, I have no experience in this at all. All I'm going to do is shove the stem in there and toss dirt on it, pat it down. There's my in-depth demo on how to grow sweet taters. But what's really nice about this is right up there, I have the hose. So whenever I'm watering the chickens and other stuff, I can just spray right down the hill over here and give these a little bit of water. I don't know if I'm going to get any sweet potatoes. And the thing is, I'm not much of a sweet potato fan as far as eating them. I've never been a sweet potato person. So if I do get any potatoes from this, any sweet potatoes, by the way, sweet potatoes grow underground, whereas the vines go crazy above ground. They're not like a regular potato at all, except that they put their potatoes underground. They're sweet. They have vines instead of regular plants. And you use them in all different kinds of recipes, you know that. I don't. I've never been into sweet potato pie or sweet potatoes for Thanksgiving, anything like that. It's just not my thing. But Mike the dishwasher's into that. And so I figured, what the heck? I'll grow them for him. All right. Well, I got a few left, and I got a place that I think I want to put these. Well, I think that pretty much does it for today's gardening. I hope you guys had a good time. I enjoyed showing all the fun stuff of the garden. I know this was an extra long program, but every now and then, what the heck? You need a feature-length film. Plus, you got to see all kinds of good stuff. Good old-fashioned gardening updates. The stuff that I really, really enjoy doing. If you have any questions, you just want to say hi or comment on all the nonsense going on here, post it in the comment section below. I'm always glad to hear from you. Until next week, have a great day, everybody. Hey, Tiki. Aw. She's not having a great day. She wants me out here.